Welcome to Park Place Lanes in Windham, New Hampshire for this match, which is part of the Mixed Teams Tournament, the fifth annual edition of this event. This match is taking place on Sunday morning, which is the second day of the event, and it features the team captained by Craig Holbrook against the team captained by Norm Pelletier. For Craig Holbrook's team, Joanne Rosano is leading off. She's on lane 22. And Kim Pelletier is leading off for Norm Pelletier's team on lane 21. Both of these bowlers are probably pretty familiar to you if you follow the tournament circuit. Joanne Rosano has probably more tournament wins than any other active woman bowler. And Kim Pelletier has enjoyed success on the tour and in international team competition as well. Joanne gets off to a kind of a tough start with a 6 box, while Kim records a 9. Joanne's right on the head pin, though. She punched the spread eagle in the first box, and she does it again in the second box, so she's right on the object pin. So when you're doing that, you kind of just have to work it out as best you can, get the pins. And there's a spare by Kim Pelletier in the second box. She converts the 6-10. So she's going to jump out to a little bit of an early lead over Joanne Rosano individually, and of course the teams. As Joanne records another 6 box, so she's only got 12 after 2. Tough start there, but long way to go. And Joanne gives way to Lynn Thompson, while Beth Powers takes over for Kim Pelletier. Lynn Thompson drops 8 on the first ball. Kim goes through the middle for 5. As I'm sure you know, Lynn has had an outstanding year. As I mentioned in the earlier match that we broadcast on YouTube, Lynn has won an awful lot of tournaments this year. She's currently the reigning Massachusetts and New Hampshire Open All Events champion, having won both of those tournaments. She also won the Lita Simino 20 String Memorial, and she's been very competitive in the Sunday Pro League and in other competition. Anyway, Lynn starts off with a spare and fills it with 7, and then Beth Powers throws a strike in the second box, so she's not about to back down. Let's see what Lynn can do with this 1-3-10, and she's got a great shot right there. Let's have another look at this strike by Beth Powers. It's as you can see, it is a very high hit in the 1-2 pocket, and the 9 and 10 are the last to go. It's a great shot right there. So Beth and Lynn are off to a good start. Now you've got Gary Santora for Craig Holbrook's team, bowling against Jeff Bougia. It looked like Gary lost the grip on the ball a little bit. Still came out of it with 5, though, and a makeable spare. Jeff with a 4 drop. Gary, as you probably know, has been Bowler of the Year on the Senior Pro Tour a couple of times, and he's also a regular on the Western New England Tour, where he won an event at the end of the year at Canal Lanes out in Southampton, Mass., western part of the state. So Gary will be just trying to clean this up for a 10, and he does. Jeff needs an out here. Jeff Bougia has only got 4, and he just goes through the middle there for a 4 box to start. Second box, Gary drops 5. And Jeff gets on the head pin, and he takes out 5, leaving the 2, 4, 5, 7, 8. A couple of spares that could be made. Neither one of them is particularly easy, though. And Gary gets, well, let's see. Missed the head pin, but got everything but the head pin. And then Jeff takes out the 5-8. So both of these guys will be open in the second box as well. Gary takes a 9. And Jeff with a 10, so that's going to bring up Dave Dupuy and Chris Powers. Dave starts with an 8 drop. Dave is another standout on the Western New England Tour. In fact, he was the bowler of the year this year. He recorded a couple of wins on that tour and several other strong finishes, so he ended up on top for Bowler of the Year honors at the end of the year. Dave lives in, is that Leicester or Spencer? I think it's Leicester. And he bowls out of Mohegan in Webster and also Colonial Lanes in Worcester. And Dave starts with a 10. Chris Powers started with a 9. Chris bowls out of Metro Bowl in Peabody. Dave drops 7, leaving the 5, 9, 10 with no wood. It's going to be a tough combination. Wow, and he gives it a great try. Cuts the 5 over into the 10, but leaves the 9. Meanwhile, Chris just goes by the object pin there on the big 5. Dave picks up the 10 box, and Chris Powers will take a 7. That brings up the team captains, anchor bowlers Craig Holbrook and Norm Pelletier. Craig Holbrook, wow, it's just been an eagle fest so far. And there is a strike by Norm Pelletier on lane 21. Meanwhile, Craig is going to try and work out this spread eagle as best he can to just try and pin. Norm threw a great ball in that 1-2 pocket, and we will take another look at it in just a moment as Craig finishes with an 8 in the first box. And let's take a look at the replay. This ball by Norm Pelletier. Nice 1-2 pocket hit, and the 2-pin goes to the sidewall and comes back to take out the 6, 9, and 10. Great shot. Craig with an 8 drop, leaving a 2-4 in the second box. And Norm punches out a half whisker. Not the way he wanted to follow up that strike, but he still has another ball to try and make it count. Craig just goes by the 2-pin. Craig lives in East Bridgewater and bowls out of Viking Recreation and where does he bowl out of? Hyde Park. And the Sunday Pro League here at Park Place. Anyhow, Craig has a 10 box in the second to Norm Pelletier's 9, so Norm has 25 after 2 and Craig with 18. So as the bowlers switch lanes, Kim Pelletier starts off with a 4 drop on lane 22, and Joanne Rosano with a 7 drop, leaving a 1-3-7. And Kim makes a backdoor spare. Missed the head pin, but got some lively pin action, and the head pin was upended from behind. Let's see if Joanne can match it. No, not quite. She missed the head pin. Well, that rolling wood almost came back and scared the head pin a little bit, but it's going to be an open for Joanne. She'll make it a 10. 22 after 3. Kim has got 33 with a ball, and she will add 7 to that, so she's got 40. And let's see what Joanne does here. She has got a 7 drop, leaves the 2, 7, 8 with a piece of wood that might make it possible. Let's see what she can do with it. Joanne came very close to making that spare. Hit a little, probably a little too high on the wood. Almost hit the cap. And I think the ball went over and got the 7, but nothing took out the 8. So it's going to be an 8 for Kim Pelletier and a 9 for Joanne Rosano. Up comes Lynn Thompson. And Beth Powers working on a strike. Lynn is working on a spare. Lynn adds 8, so she's got 35 after 2. Beth Powers with an 8 drop and an opportunity to put another mark on the board. But she goes by the object pin. Piece of wood takes out the 7, so she's got a 9 on that strike. Let's see what Lynn can do with this 8-10 split with some wood. Wow, very nice try. The front wood went right in front of the 10 pin and hit the wall and then went back in front of it again. Didn't touch it. Great try. It'll be matching 10 boxes for Beth Powers and Lynn Thompson in the third. Misses to the right on the first ball, leaves, gets a 3 drop. Meanwhile, Lynn Thompson with 9, she had a very light 1-2 pocket hit, got everything but the 3. So let's see what they can do with these. Beth hits the head pin light and takes out 4 more. Lynn Thompson with the spare, meanwhile, in the fourth box, giving her 55 with the ball. See what Beth can do with this. She comes out with a 9 box, giving her 47 through 4. So now here's Jeff Bougia on lane 22. He is off to the left and he punches out a 2 drop. I think he got the 4-8. Gary Santora, meanwhile, misses to the other side, but gets 7, leaving the 1-2-9 with a piece of wood that might help him. If he can take the 1-2, if he can hit the object pin, he's got a good chance to make the spare, but he goes by the head pin and just takes out the 9. And Jeff Bougia has a 7 box, and Gary makes a 10 on lane 21, so Jeff has got 21 through 3 to Gary's 29. And this time Jeff misses to the left again, but gets a good break, and he's got 8, leaving a 1-8 combination. And Gary, is he going to get a strike? He does. Good, solid 1-2 pocket hit by Gary Santoro. And eventually the 5 and 9 went down. And Jeff Bougia with, let's see, a nice shot there for this pair. Got a nice light hit. Let's take a look at the strike by Gary Santora. 1-2 pocket hit, and the head pin finally pushes the 5 back and into the 9 for the strike. Let's take a look at the shot that Jeff Bougia had. A nice light hit. Usually to make that leave, you need a light hit. You can carry it with a heavy hit, but a light hit gives you a chance to get it off the sidewall, and that's exactly what happened there. So Jeff and Gary both have marks in the fourth frame. So now Chris Powers is up on lane 22, and Dave Dupuis on 21. They both missed to the left. Chris with a 4 plus. Is that a... Yeah, it's a 4 drop. And he makes a great shot right there to make that spare. That's a tough spare when you take out the 2, 4, 7, 10. And he was able to really hit high on the head pin and take that out. See what Dave can do in the third box with his last ball, and he just takes 1. So he's got 28 through 3. And here's a replay of the shot by Chris Powers. Very, very solid on the head pin, and the 3 and 6 go to the sidewall and come back and get the 9. Nice shot there. Let's see what Chris can put on it. He's got 9. A light 1-2 pocket hit leaves him with the 3-pin. And Dave Dupuy also with a light hit in the 1-2 pocket, but he gets a strike out of it. And Chris Powers picks up the spare with no problem. So matching marks for Dave and Chris. And let's take a look at this strike by Dave Dupuy. Very light hit, but the head pin goes to the sidewall and generates a lot of action and takes out the entire right side. Well, since another pin came off the other sidewall, but made good use of the walls in any case. And here's Norm Pelletier, and there's another spread eagle. Everybody's doing it. And Craig Holbrook with a 6 drop, leaving the diamond on the right side, the 3-5-6-9. Wow, Craig punches the 3-pin out of the diamond. He hit the object pin, but that's all he got. Norm Pelletier takes a 9, and Craig Holbrook takes an 8. Let's take a look at the replay and see how Craig plucked out that 3-pin. Very nice shot there. Very close to exactly where he wanted to go, but it was just a little bit too full, and the 3 goes between the 5 and 9, and the ball went between the 6 and 9. Norm has a half Worcester left, and Craig with a half Worcester right. They just, both of them crossed over. Let's see what Norm can do with this. Is it going to go? Not quite. Great bid by Norm Pelletier. And Craig Holbrook gets 4 more, so he's got 1, 1, 6, 7, 10. Norm Pelletier makes the 10. And Craig Holbrook with a nice shot for a 10 box. So, through 4 boxes, Norm Pelletier's team has 2-15. With a couple of marks to fill, and Craig Holbrook's team has 207 with 3 marks to fill. And we will be back shortly with another segment of this match from Park Place Lanes at the Mixed Teams.